Hello everyone and welcome to the course of Mechanical System Design, in which we are learning about design of machine tool gearboxes. In the previous lecture, we learned about structural formula. It is a mathematical expression giving information about the number of speed steps in each stage. We have written structural formula for 12-speed gearbox in the last lecture. We could obtain total 18 structural formulae and we have to decide the best structural formula out of these 18 structural formulae. For that purpose, we need to draw structural diagram. In this lecture, we will learn how to draw the structural diagram from available structural formulae. Structural diagram is a graphical representation of structural formula. Let us understand the procedure of drawing a structural diagram by considering the first structural formula which we had obtained in the previous lecture. The general form of a structural formula is Z equal to P1X1, P2X2, P3X3 and so on. Thus, we have the first structural formula as 12 equal to 2122. 3, 4, where 12 is equal to Z, that is total number of speed steps in the gearbox, 2 is P1, 1 is X1, 2 is P2, 2 in the bracket is X2, 3 is P3 and 4 is X3, which also says that in the first stage we have got 2 speed steps, in the second stage we have got 2 speed steps, and in third stage we have got 3 speed steps. In the second stage, 2 adjacent speeds are separated by 1 speed step. In second stage, 2 speed steps are separated by 2 speed steps. In third stage, 2 speed steps are separated by 4 speed steps. We will understand what these numbers in brackets or x1, x2, x3 mean while drawing the structural diagram. The first step is draw n plus 1 number of vertical lines, where capital N is the number of stages in a gearbox. Thus, we have drawn 4 vertical lines because this is a 3-stage gearbox. A 3-stage gearbox will have total 4 shafts, so we can also say that we can draw number of vertical lines equal to number of shafts in a gearbox. The space between two shafts can be called as a stage. Thus, 2-1 is the structural formula for first stage, 2-2 for the second stage and 3-4 for the first stage. It is the representation of the same structural formula for the ease of understanding while drawing the structural diagram. Next step is draw Z number of horizontal lines where Z is equal to total number of speed steps in a gearbox. This is a 12 speed gearbox, so we have drawn 12 horizontal lines. It should also be noted that the first speed is mentioned at the bottom and the last speed is mentioned at the top. Another thing that should be noted is that all these speeds N1 to N12 are arranged in geometric progression. So, they are not uniformly distributed. However, we have drawn them on equal distance as if they are equally spaced. Now, this is possible only if this y-axis is having a log scale. Therefore, the distance between two speed steps is given by log to the base 10 phi, where phi is the geometric progression ratio of a gearbox. The distance between N2 and N3 will also be log to the base 10 phi and so on. The next step is from midpoint of shaft 1, draw P1 number of lines on shaft 2 separated by X1. In this structural formula, P1 is equal to 2 and X1 is equal to 1, which means from the midpoint of shaft 1, we have to draw two lines which are separated by one speed step. Next step is, from each point on shaft 2, draw P2 number of lines on shaft 3 separated by X2 and so on. In this structural formula, P2 is equal to 2 and X2 is equal to 2. Thus, we have to draw two lines separated by two speed steps from shaft 2 to shaft 3. This procedure has to be repeated for each point on shaft 2. Now, for all the point on the shaft 3, we have to draw three lines separated by four speed steps in this fashion. Here, the first speed step is at N12, the second speed step is at N8, and the third speed step is at N4, separated by four speed steps. The procedure has to be repeated for all the points on shaft 3. It should be ensured that all points on last shafts are assigned. None of the point is getting repeated and diagram is symmetric about horizontal midline. This structural diagram is satisfying all these conditions and hence it is acceptable. Let us draw a structural diagram for two more structural formulae. The second structural formula is 2-1-3-2-2-6 and the third structural formula is 3-1-2-3-2-6. Let us start with the second structural formula. We have to draw two lines separated by one speed step from the midpoint of first shaft. For each point on shaft 2, we have to draw three lines separated by two speed steps. The procedure has to be repeated for all the points on shaft 2. From each point on shaft 3, we have to draw two lines separated by six speed steps. The procedure has to be repeated for all the points on shaft 3. All the points on last shaft are assigned, none of the point is getting repeated and the diagram is symmetric about horizontal midline. So this structural diagram is acceptable. Let us draw a structural diagram for the third structural formula. From the midpoint of shaft 1, we have to draw three lines separated by one speed step each. It can be noted that all three points are lying midway of the speed steps, but this is acceptable on the intermediate shafts. It will not be acceptable for the last shaft. From all the points on shaft 2, we have to draw two lines separated by three speed steps in this fashion, and it has to be repeated for all the points on shaft 2. From each point on shaft 3, we have to draw two lines separated by six speed steps, and it has to be repeated for all the points. Again, all the points on the last shaft are assigned, none of the point is getting repeated, and the diagram is symmetric about horizontal midline. Thus, the third structural diagram is also accepted. We have to draw a structural diagram for all 18 structural formulae, and then we have to proceed to find out the best possible structural diagram. The method to find out the best possible structural diagram is called as node method of optimization, which we are going to learn in the next lecture. Thank you.